Welcome to a brand new skilling video. My name is Vybava Ramadoss, and I'm a product manager on Azure Storage for Kubernetes. In previous videos, we've talked about best practices on running stateful workloads with Kubernetes on Azure. Today, we will deep dive into how you can protect your production scale workloads and recover from failures. On the agenda for today, we will cover different data protection considerations and recovery scenarios as you think about your different production workloads, as well as do a backup and restore demo for a stateful workload on Azure. With that, let's get started. Over the last few years, we are seeing a significant increase in stateful production workloads running with Kubernetes on Azure. These workloads include databases, for example, MongoDB or MySQL, big data applications like Cassandra, machine learning applications like Apache Spark or Kubeflow, as well as a plethora of other applications like messaging apps, CI/CD systems, or CMS. These workloads leverage different types of storage, including block, file, and object storage options, which are exposed via CSI drivers that are deployed and configured in our Kubernetes environments. Now, as you run these workloads at production scale, it is important for you to think about data protection options and some key considerations. These include ease of configuration, simplicity of ongoing operations, application awareness, so you can restore an entire application, as well as, of course, cost effectiveness. Let's look at these one by one. With ease of configuration, we have a number of built-in platform capabilities like incremental snapshots that will always ensure that you are able to capture data with high fidelity. When it comes to operational simplicity, a number of enterprises use open source technologies like Valero, which provide built-in automation, not just for you to restore volumes, but also cluster state. Next up, ensuring that your entire application is up on restore is critical. We have a number of integrated partner solutions that provide application awareness with the right hooks in place for you to control this at the resource, namespace, or at the entire cluster level. Last but not least, ensuring that you can leverage the lowest cost options on the platform is critical. With Azure Blob Storage, you can use lifecycle management to tear down data to cooler storage for long-term retention. In addition to these considerations, you also need to look at different types of failures and recoveries. Let's look at the first scenario. Here, you may have lost your volume data, and this could be because of an accidental delete or an incorrect update. Say somebody dropped a table, and you want to be able to restore this back to a previous good state. In the second scenario that you have here, your node becomes unavailable. An example of this may be during a node upgrade operation. In this case, you want to be able to ensure that not just your volumes are up, but also your app data is recoverable, say to another node pool. In the last scenario, the call out here is disaster recovery. In this case, your entire cluster is down. Say there's a regional outage. Of course, that's super rare. But in this case, what you want to do is ensure that your volumes are up, but also your cluster state is recoverable, so your entire cluster is up in your target region. Now let's take a look at some key storage capabilities that enable and help bolster data protection. First up is snapshots. For all of our different volume types, we enable you to create fast incremental snapshots that allow you to capture changes at high fidelity and restore volumes from these snapshots. In addition to this, we also support geo-replicated or globally redundant storage, which provides a passive secondary that allows you to then bring up volumes at failover. This can be used, for example, with our standard files and blobs. On a similar line, we have enabled cross-region replication with Azure NetApp files, which leverages NetApp's Snap Mirror technology to replicate to a passive secondary in a paired region. You can sign up for this capability in preview at the aka.ms link. To further support cross-region data protection, we are announcing the preview of cross-region copy of snapshots for Azure Disks. These snapshots will be incremental, enabling fast and simple restore in your target region. You can try out this functionality today in preview by signing up at the aka.ms link. Now let's take a quick look at a demo on how you can back up and restore your application using Valero on Azure. Here you see a Kubernetes cluster that's running in Azure on West US 2, and this is running Kubernetes version 1.21. So in this environment, we have a stateful set that's running with MySQL. You can see the stateful set here. See, this is the MySQL stateful set. And then this also leverages a PVC, which is a managed disk PVC, which is using ZRS as part of this configuration. Now, what we have done is created a database and a table as part of this server, and we have populated some data on it. So let's take a quick look via a pod that's a MySQL client. So here you see I'm initializing a MySQL client, and I'm running a select statement saying select from ZRS test message. Here you see the result, meaning that this is the data that is populated in this table. Now that we've seen this information, what we're going to do is we're going to assume that something really bad happened, that someone dropped this table or someone messed up the data. And what we're going to do is we're going to take backups so that in those scenarios, we're able to restore to a previous good copy. Now, let me go ahead and create a backup of this table using Valero. And how I'm going to do this is by issuing Valero backup create. I'm giving my backup a name, which is backup v1, and I'm pointing this at my default namespace. Great. Now, Valero has submitted this backup successfully. What we're going to do is quickly look at the describe to ensure that this was indeed done successfully. So I'm going to issue the describe. And here you see that this is completed. So we know that the backup was done successfully. Now, what we're going to do now is delete that stateful set and those PVCs and see what happens on restore. Let me go ahead and delete the stateful set. I'm going to then go ahead and delete the PVC that we just looked at as well. So there you go. And this PVC will now finally remove all of the remnants of that stateful set that was running in the cluster. What you will see next is that when we issue the restore operations, we now have to determine whether that stateful set and PVC were able to come back into the environment successfully. Now you see that the PVC is indeed deleted. I'm going to go ahead and issue a Valero restore from the snapshot that we created previously, which is MySQL backup v1. Now here you see that this was completed successfully. What we're going to do next, do a watch on the pods to make sure that they're all up and running so we can validate that stateful set indeed does come back. Here you see that the pods in the stateful set are starting to initialize. And what this should really do is not just bring up the two pods that were part of the stateful set, but also bring up the persistent volumes that were mounted to this application. Great. There you see that the pods are running now. And now what we can do next, once we see that this is running, is check out if we got our PVC back. So let's check that out. Awesome. Our PVC is back as well, and it's bound to the application, as well as it is the same capacity that we expected at the point when we took the backup. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to recreate that client pod for MySQL and issue the same select statement to ensure that we're seeing the same data that we had prior to when the stateful application and PVC was dropped. So let's go ahead and do that. Here you see I'm issuing a run command with that client and issuing that same select statement, which is a select star from ZRS test. Woohoo! There, we see that the data is back and that it was restored to a previous good state. In addition to open source options, we have a number of integrated data protection solutions from our partner ecosystem. These solutions offer in-cluster, cross-cluster, as well as cross-region disaster recovery, and also with application awareness. These solutions protect different volume types on the platform, offering low RPO, low RTO solutions. In addition, these are tightly integrated with Azure Blob Storage to ensure that you get long-term retention. We work extremely closely with these partners to ensure that you have a seamless end-to-end experience leveraging these solutions on Azure. Once again, thank you very much for joining us today. We would love to hear your feedback on our surveys. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to reach out to us at AskContainerStorage@Microsoft.com. Have a great day.